Madame?
Yes?
News. Where have you been these past moons? The whole city's talking about nothing else but the Mad Magister. 30 dead novices.
News.
Where have you been these past moons? The whole city's talking about nothing else but the Mad Magister. 30 dead novices.
Huh?
How could something like this happen?
What? You mean the living dead, the Watirs everywhere, the frenzied civilians? I'd say this country's seen better times. But at least something happens. It makes this place less boring.
Madame?
A fellow traveler. Ha! Greetings.
Stay where you are. You broke the law, and you will not get away with this. Pay your fine right now. You're headed straight to prison.
Hey, I know you. I don't know who you think you are. But no one breaks the law and gets away with it. There are two ways we can do this. Fine. But believe me, next time you won't get off so easily.
Malthus blessings.
Madame?
And here we are. Welcome to Ark. I've got some things to take care of here. So let's meet at the market once you're ready to meet Grandmaster Teolor Orenthiel and his mages in person, alright?
By his own son, Nerazil, yeah. But roughly 2.5 years ago, he suddenly appeared back in Enderal, accompanied by a handful of mages who once fought against him in the Great War. Weird, I know, but that's how it was.
He did, yeah. It seems that something happened between him and them that made them sort out their issues, you could say. They're allies now, and frankly, nobody quite knows why.
You can imagine what kind of uproar that caused among the Holy Order itself. But in the end, Orenthiel got things his way. You can say what you want about him, but he never lost his charisma, that's for sure. You're telling me. But apparently their alliance has something to do with this red madness. I guess we'll see what happens. Oh. All right then. Ark is divided into five districts, not counting the harbor. If you're looking to gear up, I guess the market would be the place to go. If it's magical supplies and alchemy you need, however, you'd best try your luck in the nobles' quarters. But prepare yourself for some dismissive looks. Finally, there's the temple, which is hard to overlook. Normal citizens are not permitted to enter it, but if all goes according to plan, you'll soon see it from the inside. Yeah, it doesn't, and it isn't. The Undercity's a cluster of caves directly beneath our feet. And down there is where the poor and the sick live. Not a place I'd recommend you visit, at least not unless you're looking for mischievous things. Great. Then see you later and enjoy your stay.
Huh?
Noble citizens of Ark, lick your lips in untamed desire as the ambrosial smells of our unrivaled friend. You there! You look as if you could do with a fine loaf of our unrivaled fresh and tasty bread. Certainly, a pleasure for the young and the old, for the tall and the small.
Madame?
Between cobblestone and excretion, between darkness and light.
Hurrah! Hurrah! Advance the fleet! Always forward! Always forward!
Oh, you're not from around here, are you?
I know that accent.
What the? I beg your pardon, but by the righteous path, this is incredible! I've never heard anything like this before. Tell me, my lady, where did you learn this? Who taught you poetry? Blazes, you're self-taught. Malthus truly did... Well then, I hope this is not too much of a leap, but does your first line, the one with the dancing elder between fire and ice, deal with the socio-sexual isolation of old people in feudal societies? I may be wrong, but that was the first thought that came to my head. No, not at all. I was particularly moved by how you used onomatopoeia in line 4 and 6. Do these brutal noises at the end of each verse symbolize the hedonistic, violent way of life among the common people who have absolutely no regard for the lonely man? Phew. Well, that's a tough one. And then, suddenly, justice ends him. And I have to say, how you use the uneven number of verses as a metaphor for the discord that results from such a lifestyle is nothing short of brilliant. Well, you know what? They wouldn't. The common people, they don't even understand when I tell them I'm a poet. Poet, they ask? What kind of profession is that? Easy answers. That's what people long for.
Yeah, that should be it.
But you know what? I would rather die hungry than become one of those soulless potboiler artists who make a fortune off their stupid stories. Like Jonas Schmid does. Do you know him? Mundane rubbish. That's all he writes. But you'll find it on every bookshelf. What? What kind of question is that? How can something that so many people like not be rubbish? Of course! Not everyone has been blessed with an artist's intellect, you know. There are two kinds of writers. Small rhymes who give the common people fodder that helps them feel smart, and true artists who want more from life. Those who create, with no greed for gold and fame, bound solely by the calling of the muse. Of course I am. I wish it weren't true, but it is. Hymn of the Desert King.
Yes?
Dark as the sun, light as the night. Thousand raindrops, red and small.
An obulus, my dame, please. The Lord will redeem you for your kindness.
Walk class. Yes.
Yes?
So many strange people.
Well, isn't it nice?
That's it. And why is it Malphas who carries the Sun Temple on his back? Isn't that a gesture of servitude?
No, Malphas carries the Sun Temple because he also carries humanity. Without the benevolence and sublimity of the... What?
Well, look who's arrived. Did you have any problems finding your way around? This city can be quite a maze if you don't know it.
Right, you're from Ostian. I almost forgot.
They're quite fascinating, these places, aren't they? You can climb high, and you can fall just as deep. And every place vibrates with life. Well, I do. Here, put this on. And before you ask, yes, it's necessary. Just trust me.
Huh. Wait, the weapon you got there. I really hope you use it for the right cause.
So, about this fever. Usually those gifted with magic have to tell it to the Order, and then pass a ritual that teaches them how to deal with their magic. The journey to the water is what they call it. Once they've passed that, the fever reduces to a double level, and new Arcanists have their names registered in some kind of holy book. But there are other ways to get rid of the fever, and I hope my employer can tell you about them. Okay, almost there.
Look, blessed madam.
Hold it, my sir. No civilians beyond this point without us. The permission. Who are you and what leads you to this holy place?
Business. I'm Jaspar Delvera, and I work for the Naramese mages.
The mercenary. And who's your companion?
Marija de Luna from Ostian. Esteemed holder of de Luna's Empire of Tender Fragrance, the most prestigious perfumery in all of Vin. Archmagister Marigil sent for her. Didn't he tell you?
The Archmagister? Well, that does sound like him. Fair enough, you may pass. But show this place the respect it deserves, Miss Mary. You too, my Dame de Luna.
You have my word, fair lady. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that went better than expected. Hey, it worked, didn't it? That's all that matters. Nobody will suspect someone who's already in the temple. Anyway, I think it's about time I tell you a little bit more about this employer of mine. His name is Constantine Firespark, and he's one of Narathzal Orenthiel's former followers, which the new Grand Master, Teolor Orenthiel, brought here by ship about 2 years ago. That means he's one of the former arch-enemies of the Order. They usually wear green, while the Order wears white or red. That should make it easy for you to tell them apart. Firespark's pretty much the eldest of Narathzal's mages, and quite well-versed in magic, at least from what I've heard. Plus, he's a very gentle and likable fellow, which is why even the Keepers like having him around. Let's hope he can tell us a thing or two about these visions, and help you get rid of the fever. Come, follow me. Huh?
Keep walking.
This is holy ground, Outlander. You do not belong here.
This just doesn't make any sense. Why can't...
This is holy ground, Outlander. You don't belong...
Just might work.
All right, here we are.
No. That's not how you do it.
Let's hope he knows.
Blasted! I'm just being careful. We have to.
Give me that thing now.
Ouch!
Blasted, blistering blazes! That's what you get for working with fumblers. I told you, we should
fire spark.
Be careful. What? Now, who the heck are you? Can't an old man have a moment to himself?
You hired me. The Magister, don't you remember?
Oh, right. Joseph the Scrounger. So, why are you here? Had any luck?
Just spar. And yeah, we did find something. I...
Suggest you first of all tell me when I allowed you to drag your flings up here. Do you need me to explain the meaning of the words highly and confidential to you?
I'm sure there's a lot you can explain to me, but let's save that for later. This particular lady over here needs your help, to be frank. Arcane fever.
Is that so? And what exactly has that got to do with me? Let the Keepers and their holy rituals take care of it. What is it with the costume, anyway?
This woman's magic is different, Meiser. Just feel her aura, and you'll see it. Plus, she's from Naren, just as you are.
Well, all right then, for nostalgia's sake. I really hope you're not wasting my time, though. Working with these religious buffoons is bound to make any rational-thinking person go bonkers. Anyway, that chair over there. Take a seat, and I'll have a look at that fever of yours. All right, then. This will tickle a little. You're right. This aura does feel different. Complex somehow and... powerful. And do you really want to tell me you've only recently discovered that talent of yours? With that aura, I'm surprised that you haven't turned into an Obaya by now. Fine. I, well, that is, we will help you. But first, tell me everything. How you got that magic, and how you met that scrounger. I see. Regarding this vision thing, I think that your mind simply played a trick on you there. Not that it's much of a surprise, considering what you've been through. Actually, you were quite lucky that the sudden outburst of your glance didn't blow your head right off. By all that's holy, I won't start playing your tutor now. If you don't know about the basic functioning of magic, then read something from Balador Goldenstein.
The glance on the sea of eventualities. Alongside, but apart from the reality we're in right now, exist countless other realities, in which some events have different outcomes, so to speak. A version of this very same room, for example, with the very same people in it, only that Meister Firespark's beard is on fire. And what defines an Arcanist, someone capable of magic, is that he or she can see those other realities and let parts of them come true.
Well, look at that, Jasper. You surprise me.
That's what I'm being paid for.
How powerful an Arcanist is depends on three factors. How far away are the eventualities that he can see? How well he can bring parts of them into our reality? And finally, how well his mind can handle seeing other realities simultaneously with ours? Lighting a candle is easier than calling a meteor from the sky, to speak plain Enderal. But, as I said, read Goldenstein if you're interested in the topic. I'm not going to waste any time with lectures. Well, that's probably a sign that you should go easier on the booze. Skill, whether of physical or magical nature, isn't gained through touching some stones, but even though this screwball Enderalean talk of paths and predeterminations tries to tell us otherwise. Ah, well, if that's what you want to believe, go for it. I, in any case, have never come across such a phenomenon in over 50 years of studying magic. And now we should...
It all begins with the dreams.
What the blasted, blistering blazes? Does this room look like the bosom of a whore to you? Or what makes you think you can go around then you get your fingers on? These documents are confidential, for heck's sake. I knew it was a mistake to hire a thug like you. Lashery always had a weakness for...
Correct me if I'm wrong, but I remember you telling me something about dreams that led you and Teal'or Orenthiel here, didn't you, Meister? And you told me that in this vision of yours, the Veiled Woman said this. It all begins with the dreams.
What? Is that true? Oh. Then this near-death experience you had before you woke up on the shore. Tell me again, what exactly did you see in it? A room? Well, this is strange indeed. Anyway, for now all that matters is that we get that magic of yours under control. Whatever you clairvoyanced back there is of no use to us if you're dead as a doornail in a couple of months. Well, that's usually a plodding process. The fever you feel is a result of your mind not being able to handle all of these possibilities, so to speak. The ritual the Enderaleans practice to get the glance under control is called the Journey to the Water. Put frankly, it means 1 year of hour-long meditation, bland food, and abstinence from anything that makes life worth living. In due time, the Arcanist then learns to filter these other realities from ours, and the fever gets less and less. Anyhow, luckily enough, we Neremes know of a way to quicken that process. A shortcut, if you will. I'm not capable of performing it, but another one of us is. Her name is Lashery, and you should seek her out as soon as possible. She's currently in a ruin called Old Rationgrad, not far from Ark. Just tell her that I sent you. Give me that map of yours. Okay, now you'd have to be a total idiot to miss it. I recommend leaving for the ruin straight away. And you, Joseph, you're going to come with me and show me what your trip to the Sun Coast brought forth. Hopefully, more than a bottle of honey wine and a hangover.
Quite a character, isn't he? Here, I owe you this for your help back in Riverville. And in case you're in the mood for a mug of ale and a good chat, just drop by the Dancing Nomad in the Stranger's Quarter. With all that said, good luck mastering your magic, my fair lady. I'll see you around.
This is holy ground, Outlander. You do not belong here.